My name is Danielle Edwards. Today I celebrate International Women's Day in solidarity with all the other women in the world. I pressed for progress when I appeared in the courtrooms in my home country, Dominica, as a young female advocate very early in my career.
My name is Lano Fonua, and I pressed for progress when I managed the Tonga Women's Sevens rugby team. I think it's really important when you have the opportunity, particularly in areas where or sports that women haven't been involved in traditionally, to give them the opportunity if you are able to. Now there is women's rugby in Tonga, and it's really growing. Now we have women's coaches and lots more players.
My name is Joanna Pelaez, and I press for progress when I challenge assumptions about women by conquering one country in the world at a time by taking in different challenges. The best example that comes to my mind right now, it's when I moved to Africa to contribute to the professional and education development of a group of teenage mothers that live in a village in Cameroon.
My name is Daniel Bess. To me, it's instructive that International Women's Day falls on March the 8th, which is actually my mother's birthday. She instilled in her four children values that have stayed with us throughout our lifetime, values of discipline, self-respect, working hard. And now, as a father of two daughters in their 20s, one of the things that I strive to do would have been to pass on those values which she taught us at such a young age. So to all of the strong, powerful, capable, engaging women out there across our region and indeed the wider world, I say happy International Women's Day 2018.
I am Sophia Prescott. It's an honor to speak to you today on International Women's Day 2018, a day which recognizes the contribution of women to society in both their personal and professional lives. I appreciate the contribution of those persons who have greatly influenced my life.
My name is Tracy Richards, and International Women's Day means so much to me. It is the achievement of women throughout the world. It is a catalyst for change as it regards to gender equality. We have made great strides as it regards to our struggles. We have pertaining to leadership. We have prime ministers of Aruba. We have the premier of Turks and Caicos, Dominica in the Caribbean region. We have Jamaica, Trinidad, have all had female leaders.
My name is Toussaint Boyce, and I believe that every day presents a fresh opportunity to achieve that balance of gender equality, that initiative that says we should leverage as best as possible the ideals of men and women, boys and girls, in equal fashion. I think in observance of International Women's Day, the best example I can think of that celebrates that ideal is that I once led a department of 18 persons that were all women. I think that unique opportunity provided me with great insight and also to benefit from a very productive work environment.
My name is Tanya Miller. International Women's Day seeks to celebrate the resilience of women under everyday and extraordinary circumstances. It shines a spotlight on how women pull from their reservoir of compassion and strength to ensure that not only their voice is heard, but that it has a meaningful impact. I press for progress by teaching my son that the contributions that one makes at home or to society should not be limited by gender.
My name is Sonia Hartley, and International Women's Day means to me a big deal because it recognizes women across the world. It gives women an opportunity to speak out and to let their voices be heard, and that representation is so much, it means so much to people because some women are not heard. So when we have something like this where we record and it goes throughout the world, well, that is an exciting thing. So to me, International Women's Day is a very great thing to have, and it's good for the women out there.